We are creating an app, age calculator. First we open the Xcode. Then create a new Xcode project. Select a single view app. Click next. Product name is age calculator. Select storyboard language Swift and next. Save it in anywhere, like I am saving in my desktop. Yeah, go to main storyboard. On a view controller, first choose a label, give it to constraint top constraint from top to 16 and horizontally in container. Now rename it with like my age. Now take a label again a label. Rename it as date of. Take a text field. Add in placeholder date of birth. Select date of birth. Same give it to constraint, like from top it's 16, from leading it's 16 and from trailing it also 16. Yeah. Now take a button. Change button label, calculate age, give some constraint, top 16, width 200, sorry. Height 50 and width 200. Along with horizontally in containers. Now make a IB actions and connect these fields with your view controller. So first we adding a new screen, open view controller in it, make some IV outlets like age label, date of DOB text field, for button we need a action of button, so we are taking an action calculate age button action. Now first we have done with our design, so we will close it. Now first we will adding a date picker. So adding a date picker, you can search on Google how to add a date picker in Swift programmatically. So like I search this display programmatically creating date picker with the using a UI navigation button. So we are not using a navigation button, but we are creating a date picker. So first there are two ways you can just copy paste. From it to here, so you can see first we creating a it will need a date picker object. So first we are adding a where date picker UI date picker. Now you need a toolbar. Same for toolbar, you need to create an object of toolbar. So where toolbar is equal to UI toolbar. Or you can create an object here like they create here. Now we go to one to one line. First we are creating a object of date picker with providing some react to it where it will be show. So we showing it x0 y0 width self dot view dot frame dot width like width of the phone, and the height is 200. Background color is white and mode is we just need a date. So we are selecting the mode as a date. We need to where we need to show it. So it will be shown in center where we need it on the bottom. Or we can show it on center too. Now adding it on the view. Same we are setting some toolbars. Adding the button on toolbar for done and cancel. If you select that done, so then done, and then otherwise cancel. Two more thing. We just want to show the date picker when user click on the text field. So for this, first we are calling the you did load. like this will be adding on the button click. So the function is calling on the button add tab, but we need it in on the text view. So we are just searching open date picker on text field input view. Same like here they will create a done button, space button and cancel button, toolbars, but they need an accessory views in text, or also they need a date picker on text input view. So we are doing the same thing here. In the heading of view, we are just adding did not need a center here dot input view is equal to date picker dot input series views equal to toolbar. So we did not need where we need to set it, we just want to show it. So first we check it, it's working or not. It's unable to show any view. We will close the simulator and run again. So you can see it's a my age and text field button. So first we click on the text field and you can see it will be open, but I think due to dark mode we are unable to see. So for this purpose first, we do not need to hide . So we change the dark mode to selecting a date to show the date of birth. We have a date formatter here. setting the style of date. Getting date object from picker. So let date equal to date picker dot date. Now converting this date to string format to send on text field. So we are just taking the DOB text field dot text equal to date formatter. We need one here. Dot. Like you see that there are so many functions. We just need a function which will convert the date to a string. So the argument in on date and return type on a string. So you can see the string function. So we have the date object. So you can see it's a 5 June 2020 and then we will done it, or it will show June 5, 2020. Again, if we click on it and we select any other date, so it will then done button, it will show. If we press cancel, then it will be nothing here. We change date, but press cancel, then it's nothing will be here. So our date picker is running. Now we need to calculate it, but one more thing, date of birth can be more than today, so we need to set the maximum date. So we are going on date object, maximum date is equal to date object. The date object give us the today dates, so you can check it here. Now we will click on input view. You can see we can't go on the more date from today. It will come back on the here because the date of birth can't be more than today. So now we need to calculate the date. So calculation of date, we need today date. We can get it from the date object. Along with, we need the date of the date of birth. So we have here the selecting date of birth. So we create a variable where date of birth. So type date. We will create it with the today date. By default, it will be take a today date. Now if user did not select date of birth, then there is no need to show the or calculate the age. So first we will check if let we can make it optional here. It will be better for us. Will be the date. So what should we check it? If let DOB equal to date of birth. If we have date, because we will set date here only, otherwise it will be nil. So if we have a date of birth, then we can calculate the date. First we take a variable for today. We need a reference of calendar, so let calendar equal to root. Check. We can take help of Google again. So here it will show the component. Date component. So we have date of birth here. So we are finding the date component from the date of birth and today in year, month and days. So now let age in year equal to component dot year. Let age in month equal to component dot month. Let age in days equal to component dot days day. Now print on the label. Is label dot text equal to age in years age in month age in days these are in int with the nil value. So we make it, we provide some default value. Now we run it. If we select the today date of calculated dates, then it's 0 day, 0 month, and 0 days because this is today dates. But now if we select my date of birth, it will be August. Oh, first we need to sell year 91 and date. And then month August, then done. It's my date of birth. Then I calculate my age. It's 28 years 9 months and 5 days. It's perfect. So we will revise this. What we done, first we go to storyboard, create some, take a label for calculation of age, provide it constraint, take a text field to select a date, and then age button to calculate the age. Now we go to view controller, creating some IB outlet for storyboards along with IB action of button. Then now we write a function to create a date of picker, date picker programmatically. So in date picker, first we create an object with some frame. So we provide the frame to date object like x0, y0 with the width of the phone and height 200. Then we provide some background graph. We did not need to provide background graph, it will be take automatically. We need a mode of date. So there will be two mode of date, date and date time. Then we set mode of date. Then we set the maximum date, because date of birth can't be more than today. Then we set it in the input view. The input view parts will be done for us, like it's working like keyboard. If we did not set any input view to the text field, then it will open keyboard on click. But if we set any other things like a date picker, date picker or some image picker or something else, then it will be show this part. So we will set on date picker in the place of keyboard. Now we will set toolbar. So we provide the bar style, translant, tint color to set the color of buttons on the toolbar, and fit. Now we adding some buttons for action. So we have two button, done or cancel. We provide a space to separate these buttons. And add them create done button space between button cancel button. Now we add these button in on toolbar. Add above. We will enable the user interaction and set as input accessories. Input accessories is the thing which will work as an accessories on the text field. So we have an input view, we have a date picker as an input view, and we set an accessories to which work with the input view. Did not read it. We are not hiding our unhide these things. These are toolbar style. Now on done button. Done button. We for done but after click on done button we need a date selected by the user. Also we need to close the date picker. So to close the date picker. We are forcefully and editing because the like we will click on text field, it start the editing. We can edit by keyboard, we can edit by date picker, or we can edit by any other input view. So we will close this, we will stop this editing with forcefully with the function add editing. Along with we are creating a date formatter, we provide it as a medium. We can provide it anything like in which format we need date. Find the date from date picker and attach it with the text field. Same for cancel button. In cancel button we did not need any date because cancel by the user, we just need to close the date picker. In calculate button, we just need to calculate these things. First, we will check if user select any date or not. Like in this function, like we restart the if user click on date picker, but he will press cancel, and now we will calculate it. But he did not select any date, so it will show nothing. Now we will take today dates, calendar reference, then calculate age from calendar reference. To calculation, first we take a data component. In date component, we need year, month, and day, so we will provide it in an array. If we need any other like time and then, we can provide it here. Now, from date component, we calculate the age in year, age in month, and age in days, and then attach it to text field.